Hello and welcome to the 7th issue of the Cars Tube Gallery. Today I only display myself in this small corner, because I want to make space for Christian's invention. It is called Spacomat, and I collected the second prize for it at the Evoke Computer Party 2014 in Cologne, Germany. The Spacomat is a software that uses a Microsoft Kinect camera as an interface to control the parameters of fractals in two or three dimensions. Actually, I can switch dimensions by putting my hands on my head. It makes sense for 3D fractals to be controlled in that manner, because the body joints also move in three dimensions. And many 3D fractals have rotation axis as parameters, which map directly to body parts. But Dr. Weisenheimer shall explain that. Every body position creates another parameter set. It is really fun to control that many parameters at the same time. The name Spacomat derives from the German word abspacken, which is a slang word for inhibited dancing. Actually, this explanation should have been made by the Dr. Weisenheimer or by the newscaster, but they have been really lazy there lately, and so it comes down to me. Nevertheless, the Spacomat has great potential, and its use is not only limited to parties. I think every retirement home should have one. Its art through movement is a beautiful and spiritual. Goddamn, who is interrupting my show? Someone is at the door. Just wait a second. Ah, whoever this is, I'm going to teach him a lesson, not to interrupt my show.
Bonjour, je suis Ophéline.
Oh, it's a girl. That changes everything. Enchanté, madame.
Enchanté. J'arrive directement de France pour t'apporter un cadeau de Bib.
Ah, je ne parle pas français. Who are you?
A gift.
Wow.
From Jérémy, aka Bib.
Jeremy always makes the nicest presents, like this Sierpinski cube I got from him in San Sebastian last year. But this one, wow, it is the most beautiful present I ever gotten. Beautiful. And what's that book you're holding?
But it's Jeremy Brunet's last creation, a collection of his fractal pictures. It's called L'Art Fractal aux Frontières de l'Imaginaire.
Wow. Jeremy Brunet, aka Bib, from the forums, published a book with all of his greatest images in very high quality. Shall we take a look?
Of course.
This is amazing.
Oh.
Some of the images were in the calendar of the forums.
Wow.
And Jeremy is one of the pioneers in the fractal art scene. And he is very active.
Magnifique.
And produced this collection of high quality images from the most recent years.
C'est chouette.
And this is an object similar to the one we have seen in the Spacomat presentation. You have seen which I'm going to hold originally today.
Mm, super.
And there are so many images, and I think this should take another look, a closer look.
Jeremy Brunet registered with the Fractal Forums at January 5th, 2009, right after the discovery of the Mandelbulb. His strong technical background let him understand the concepts very early. New techniques like hybridization techniques came just natural to him, and he has sucked up the early versions of Mandelbulb 3D to create stunning images. His book is ordered in three topics. First, abstract and unreal. Second, architecture and objects. Third, supernatural landscapes. Fractal images tend to be abstract and unnatural, but some do look like objects or architecture, some look like landscapes. We will leave the order of the book and present his work chronologically with references to the page numbers in the book. In the beginning, there were no 3D rendering software available, but in 2010, the advent of the Fractal 3D imagery, he published the enormous amount of 220 pictures. The Secret Microcity of 2010 makes use of the just released depth of field effect in Mandelbulb 3D. It was part of the 2012 Fractal Forums calendar. Venomous is an early example for a hybrid. Hybrids are the merger of two or more formulas, a concept that came naturally to Jeremy. In 2011, he had great success with the underwater amazing object. It got inspired by the exchange with other forums members about hybrid techniques. It was used in 2012 calendar as well. FabX 2100 is a snapshot from a great Zoom video into a Sierpinski hybrid. The video is linked. Take a look at it. In 2012, he published Apollo X, which is surprisingly minimalistic, for BIP usually uses a high iteration count. Rebirth of Cyclop is a hybrid of the at the time just discovered Carly box and the Mandel box. It's rendered 100% with Mandelbulb 3D. Similar to the last one, not only in title, is a Rebirth of Orchid with the same hybrid setup. X-Tree uses four-dimensional modulus operation on the Mandel box, at the time freshly discovered. A bottom-top view of a tree in X shape. Fractals often look similar to trees, since trees have a fractal structure. Back to Extreme uses a high iteration count with many details and a nice color setting. In the Cave of the Beast was in the calendar 2013 for its strong perspective and fiery atmosphere. BIP is always good for surprises because he uses so many different formulas. This way points to the right direction in a filigree manner. One can tell BIP knows Mandelbulb 3D inside out by now. Gardens of the Carly box is a real surprise, as it looks totally lifelike, but it's just another Carly box. In Carly box corridor we can see how BIP uses the same formula for really different outcomes and views. And again a high iteration count for explicit details. Carly's crown was created as a thank you to Carly, the discoverer of the formula, as this formula inspired BIP so greatly.
In The Treasure, he combines the Carly box with the Amazing box. He celebrates the formula's greatness by giving a full view of such a formula. It does look like the Ark of the Covenant.
Ice Age is a cover picture for this book L'Art Fractal aux Frontières de l'Imaginaire. It's from 2014. One of his last works before he started focusing on real fractal objects with 3D printers. It has a great dynamic for a picture straight from the fractal rendering software.
We have to stop here, but the book contains more than 150 images, all in the best quality, which we couldn't always provide here.
Wow, this is really an amazing book. A must-have for every fractalist on this planet. Jeremy is a really nice guy who makes very nice and beautiful presents, but this is the best I've ever gotten by him. And Jeremy, thank you for the book as well. Are you into checking out the Spacomat with me?
Avec plaisir.
That is wonderful. I just built in a two-player mode.
Oh, formidable.
Let's do it.